Greetings. I want to take this opportunity. We've chosen to use this way of reaching out to you to share some of the changes that have happened at Risen Savior and are going to take effect this week. But to begin with, I want to thank those who have greeted me with your prayers, cards, and concerns. It was just 1 week ago, this Monday, that I had my hip replaced. As you can tell, the healing is going very well, and I look forward to full recovery. I also look forward to a lot of the pain being relieved that I've experienced over quite some time now. To give you an idea of that, one of the questions I've been asked is, on the annual meeting, people saw me here at both services, but when it came time for the annual meeting, I was not here. Well, let me explain what happened. After the services, I had an episode. My heart rate went way down. I had another episode of being exhausted and dehydrated. So I spent most of that Sunday afternoon in the ER, and I thank God for those who were here to help out with that and to see me through it. But what I would like to do at this time to start this is to give you a very brief piece of what I wanted to share at the annual meeting. It's been my prayer since March when this pandemic all started, and this is simply it. Lord, please prevent Satan from using this pandemic to divide the church. Sadly, I've had to change that a little bit. My new prayer is this. Lord, please prevent Satan from using this pandemic to further divide the church. And I'm not just talking about Risen Savior, I'm talking about the church as a whole, and in fact, this country in which we live in. We live in a time where masks should be worn or masks should not be worn, and people are divided in regard to that instead of realizing situations sometimes are different, whether we should wear them when we teach or whether we should not wear them when we teach. Again, situations vary so much. It's time for us to start really loving one another like we should. And then the next step, even within that, should we isolate one another? Should we not isolate? Should we just go on to business as usual because everyone's going to get it? The divisions are everywhere. So I'm going to challenge all of us. All of us, as we make the decisions for our families of what we feel God is calling us to do, let it be what God is calling us to do. And don't let him take a back seat to other priorities that we've established. It's okay to do this, but when it comes to church, God isn't as important. Be careful how we analyze that with him. You know, over Thanksgiving, we joined together under the theme of be at peace, be thankful, be a blessing. It seems very fitting for us to use that at this particular time too. These are some of the things that have changed. Because of the severity of this disease, the Board of Worship made the tough decision to go online for our Advent services. The theme for this year, the ancestry of Jesus. This week we'll be looking at Jesus, the Son of David. The service will be available online beginning Wednesday evening at 6:30. It will be on website and available at time. If Wednesday evenings don't work for your family, please take time and listen in with your family. The offerings have been designated, as in the past, for special ministries. Follow the instructions in the video to know how to give. Another change for Wednesday evening is for the confirmation class, grades 6 through 8. The parents of the students will be receiving an email explaining how to do this class online. Wednesday, December 2nd, 9th, and 16. That means starting this Wednesday. Senior youth parents should also be watching for meeting times for high school students. We're working at sending out resources for various age groups. Please watch for these via email, and please take advantage of them. We're not living in fear because we know that God is right beside us all the way. We're trying to follow the guidelines we've been given and listening to medical experts and want to do our part to help relieve the medical field workers and to slow down the spread of this virus in ways that we can. We'll continue to worship on Sunday mornings at 8 and 10:30. Why? Part of that is because God has gifted us with a new large worship center. We're able to safely distance ourselves while still joining together. I want to encourage all of us, one, to keep Jesus before our families at home, two, to be generous, and three, to be in prayer for one another. Be sure to watch our email updates as we're on week-to-week schedule and things are changing weekly. Let's close with a prayer. Gracious Father, during this pandemic, during these changing times, help us, Lord, to remember someone who never changes, and that's your great love for each and every one of us. As we receive that love, help us to reflect it in everything that we do, that people don't see us changing our relationship with you because you never changed yours with us. So, as we go forth, may the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face shine on you and be gracious unto you. May the Lord look upon you with favor as we continue to go forth in his peace. Amen.